How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And does your iPhone need a VPN? So today I'll just go through a few maybe reasons why you might want a VPN, or maybe you don't need a VPN. So I'll just go ahead and explain the utility of using a VPN. And by the way, if you guys are interested in any of the VPNs mentioned today, you'll find links to pricing discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. Now, a VPN works using an application that you install on your iPhone. This application allows you to click connect on a server of your choice. And it works the same on any device that you're using. Simply pick a server and just connect and you're good to go. Now, when you click connect, the VPN server encrypts your data and sends it to the VPN server, commonly referred to as a secure VPN tunnel. This encrypted information cannot be accessed by anybody as it travels from your device to the VPN server. Of course, this is just a brief explanation of what a VPN is and how it works, but overall, a VPN is a very useful application for security. For example, let's just start with the first utility here, such as accessing stuff from back home on a vacation. Because when you go abroad, many websites and services from your home country become unavailable. This is because of geo restrictions set up by those websites. With a VPN, you can pretend to be back home by connecting to a server in your country. This lets you access websites from your home country even while you're away on a vacation. For example, if you're trying to access your banking account from back home, it's typically better to use an IP address from your home country so that your banking application does not think that some foreign or foreigner or somebody from a foreign country is trying to access your bank account and it could block you, whereas it just, you know, it's just you trying to access it from another country. So this is one safe way of accessing your bank account without risking getting blocked by it. Another very common reason to use a VPN, it's probably my main reason to use a VPN besides securing my device on public Wi-Fi, is watch more Netflix, because the Netflix catalog varies from country to country. And with a reliable VPN such as these three, for example, you can choose one of these and you'll be able to access multiple Netflix libraries without really having to be in any of the countries. And it goes the same for streaming foreign TV channels such as BBC iPlayer. You know, if I want to use BBC iPlayer, if I want to watch BBC iPlayer, simply connect to a UK server and I'm good to go. Now I can watch BBC iPlayer, which is exclusive to the UK. You can also watch international sports competitions, services like MLB TV, UFC Fight Pass, F1 TV, Sky Sports, BN Sports, ESPN, and Fox Sports are not available in every country. However, with a VPN, you can unblock those channels to stream more sports with your VPN, because a VPN also lets you watch local tournaments such as Wimbledon for free. You can also purchase things for cheap, because with a VPN, you can change your location, which can bring down the cost of air flight tickets, hotel bookings, and purchasing online services. It kind of opens up the world to you and you can access all kinds of markets without really having to go to these foreign markets, right? It's just with a VPN. So as far as my internet is concerned, if I just go to my IP checker right now, it'll just say that I am in the UK because I'm connected to the UK server. So as far as my internet is concerned, I'm in the UK and I can access anything within the UK as if I'm in the UK. So hopefully that answered you guys' question. And, you know, with regards to using a VPN on your iPhone, let's say you're trying to connect to a public Wi-Fi and you have billing information on your iPhone, which, let's be honest, you probably do. It's always better to use a VPN so that you don't risk your billing information. You really don't want to risk compromising any billing or financial sensitive information when you're on public Wi-Fi, because most public Wi-Fis are unencrypted and you never know who's on the other side of the administrative side of things of that network, or anyone else who's using that network who could be some kind of cyber thief. So that's it for this video. Hopefully you guys learned something. If you have any more questions, feel free to post them in the comments down below. And if you're interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to pricing discounts in the description, as well as links to full reviews if you'd like to learn more about them. Besides that, comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.